Hello students, so far we have discussed the meaning, nature, functions and principles of insurance. Now in today's lecture the focus is on the types of insurance. Now insurance can be classified on three bases. The first being on the basis of nature of insurance, then classification can be done from business point of view, and then classification from risk point of view. So briefly I will take up each one of these and explain what is meant by these types of insurance. So let's start with the first one, classification on the basis of nature of insurance. Yani insurance ka jaisa nature hota hai to uske basis pe hum isko five categories mein divide kar rahe hain. The first one is life insurance, then fire insurance, marine insurance, social insurance and then miscellaneous. अगर business की बात करें तो insurance business जो है like India में we have two types of companies, two type of insurance businesses are going on. The first one being the life insurance business and the second is the general insurance business. तो उसी के basis पे जो है insurance को हम life insurance कह सकते हैं और general insurance, इस तरह से दो categories में हम उसको divide कर सकते हैं. Nowadays another important category is also there, that is health insurance. और health insurance जो है वैसे तो previously जब तक full-fledgedly health insurance companies नहीं आई थी market में तो health insurance products were sold by life insurance companies and general insurance companies both. And even now also health insurance is sold by general insurance companies. But specifically we now have health insurance companies, यानी पूरी dedicatedly companies हैं जो कि सिर्फ और सिर्फ health insurance पर ही focus करती हैं. तो business point of view से now we can divide the insurance business into three categories as we are having three types of companies operating their business in India. First one being the life insurance, then general insurance and then health insurance. Then classification can be done on the basis of risk point of view. That means the type of risk that is covered by the insurance. Like first one being the personal insurance. Personal insurance means the risk that a person faces. तो उसमें जैसे life का risk है तो life insurance हो गया, accident insurance वो ले सकता है. So whatever the risk are faced by a person individually, so that all is covered under personal insurance. Then property insurance means any damage to the property, any loss arising because of destruction or damage caused to the property, so that is covered by property insurance. Liability insurance, that means any kind of you can say liability that arises, so any loss or any kind of risk which can be caused because of some court case or liability, so that is covered under liability insurance. Fidelity guarantee insurance means some embezzlement or fraud which is conducted which is committed by any employee, so that can be covered through fidelity guarantee insurance. So all these are I'm going to discuss now one by one. So I'll start with the first one, classification on the basis of nature of insurance. And the first category or the first type of insurance is life insurance. Now life insurance may be defined as a contract in which the insurer, in consideration of a premium, agrees to pay to the assured, that is person whose benefit, for whose benefit the policy is taken. So the insurance company, they agrees to pay this person is known as the assured, a certain sum of money on the happening of a specified event contingent on human life or at the expiry of a certain period. So for the time period for which you have taken the life insurance, if that expires, so after that the sum assured is paid, or on the happening of the event, like the risk that is being covered under life insurance is the risk of death. So in case the death is there, that event has happened, so the sum assured will be payable after the happening of the event or after the expiry of the period, certain period to the person for whom the policy is taken. Now, the risk insured against in case of life insurance is death, right? So, there are broadly four types of life insurance products which are prevailing in the market. These four types are, first one being the whole life insurance, then term insurance, endowment and annuity policies. So, what is meant by whole life, term insurance, endowment and annuity? The policies which are taken for a certain time period are known as term insurance policies. So, usme term specified hota. Let's suppose we have taken it for 5 years or 10 years or 15, 20 as per the requirement. The term is given in that, and in case of term insurance, only the risk of death is covered. So, there are no survival benefits. So, after expiry of the time period for which the insurance is taken, so no benefits is given in case the person survives. So, the sum assured is given only in case of death. So, if death occurs within the term of the insurance, then the benefit will be given. Otherwise, there are no survival benefits. Same is case with whole life, but the difference between the two is, in dono ke beech mein difference kya hai? Whole life means the insurance will continue for whole life. So, the term is not specified here. Term jo hai yahan par, uska pura life hai, yani jab tak death nahi hoti, the individual has to pay the insurance, sorry, a premium. In case of endowment, endowment policies mein jo hai, survival benefits bhi hain. That means after the completion of the insurance term, certain sum is given to the person. So survive agar karta hai, even then jo jitna bhi premium usne deposit karaya hai, that premium is given to the person. Aur risk of death to wo policies cover karti hi karti hain. Annuities are kind of pension plans. So, the principle of utmost good faith and insurable interest are the only specific principles which are applicable in case of life insurance. So, life insurance pe principle of indemnity or principle of subrogation applicable nahi hota hai. Why? Because we cannot calculate the monetary value of a life. So, we cannot say ki itna loss ho gaya hai because of the death. So, that's why the principle of indemnity and subrogation, they are not applicable. Only and only principle of utmost good faith and insurable interest are applicable in case of life insurance. The second is our fire insurance. So, a fire insurance is a contract whereby the insurer, in consideration of the premium paid, undertakes to make good any loss or damage caused by fire during a specified period. So, fire insurance policy is for a period of 1 year, after which it has to be renewed from time to time. A claim for loss by fire must satisfy these two conditions. The first one being that there must be some actual loss, and that loss must be accidental and non-intentional in nature. So, the fire insurance will be payable only if the loss is accidental. Agar janbujhkar humne usko aag laga diya hai property ko ya intentionally damage kar rahe hain, so no insurance will be given. Or fire insurance, in fact, jitni bhi general insurance hoti hain, they are for only 1 year, after which it has to be renewed. So, if somebody feels that ki mera time period expire hone wala hai and I have not availed the benefit of insurance, or wo intentionally apni property ko damage karta hai, so in that case, no benefit will be given. So, the risk covered by fire insurance is the loss resulting from fire or some cause which is proximate cause of the loss. So, if damage is caused by, let's suppose, by overheating without ignition, it will not be regarded as a fire loss within the meaning of fire insurance, because for fire insurance there has to be fire. So heating ki wajah se agar damage ho raha hai, so that is not covered under fire insurance. The next is marine insurance. तो मरीन इंश्योरेंस क्या है? इट इज़ अगेन अग्रीमेंट, ये सारे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स ही हैं, इंश्योरेंस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स हैं, वेयर बाय एन इंश्योरर अंडरटेक्स टू इंडेमनीफाई द इंश्योर्ड इन द मैनर एंड टू द एक्सटेंट देयर बाय अग्रीड अगेंस्ट मरीन लॉसेस. तो मरीन पेरल्स, पेरल्स मीन्स कॉज ऑफ लॉस. सो एनी लॉस दैट the person is incurring because of the dangers of the sea, so one needs to get protected from those losses. So that insurance is given by the type of insurance is marine insurance. So what kind of you can say perils are there, or what are the dangers that exist in the sea? For example, there may be collision with the rock, or the ship may be attacked by some enemies, or there may be some capture by pirates. So these peril, they cause destruction, damage, and maybe disappearance of ship and the damage to cargo. So marine insurance, it basically gives you insurance against these three things. That is hull insurance. Hull means the body of the ship. Then cargo insurance can be done, and freight insurance. So these three types, these are further categories within the marine insurance. तो owner जो है, ship का owner जो है, hull insurance करवाएगा, because he is more concerned about the ship. Okay, so जिसका सामान है, जो cargo है, तो that person will be more focused on the cargo insurance. So according to the need, the insurance is taken. Then next is social insurance. Social insurance has developed to provide economic security to weaker sections of the society who are unable to pay the premiums for adequate insurance. For example, pension plans, disability benefits, unemployment benefits, sickness insurance, industrial insurance. These are various forms of social insurance. तो दीज आर मेजर कैटेगरीज. देन वी हैव मिसलेनियस. मिसलेनियस में बहुत लंबी लिस्ट है जो कि हम इंक्लूड कर सकते हैं. सो मैनी टाइप्स ऑफ रिस्क विच आर बीन फेस्ड बाई इंडिविजुअल्स और कंपनीज और ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. तो वो अपनी जो भी स्पेसिफिक नीड्स के अकॉर्डिंग जो इंश्योरेंस कराते हैं, सो ऑल दैट कैन कम अंडर मिसलेनियस इंश्योरेंस. सम मेजर टाइप्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस आई हैव मैंशनड हेयर. द फर्स्ट मेजर इंश्योरेंस इज मोटर इंश्योरेंस. So the process of this fast development in the society has given rise to a number of risk, or you can say hazards. So to provide security against such hazards, many types of insurance have been developed. The first one being motor insurance. Motor insurance has been classified according to the types of vehicles. So it can be for scooter, motorcycles, they can be private cars and commercial vehicles. These commercial vehicles can further be then private and public vehicles. Then they can be goods or passengers vehicle, right? And miscellaneous. So according to the Motor Vehicles Act of 1988, No motor vehicle means any vehicle which is mechanically propelled. So that vehicle cannot ply in a public place unless it is insured against third party liability. तो यानी third party liability जो है कराना, इसका insurance कराना compulsory है, otherwise the vehicle cannot run on the roads. So after the amendment of the act, the liability for personal injury and death is now unlimited. So if there is any damage caused to the body, so if there is personal injury or death because of the vehicle, so the person causing the accident, uski jo liability hai, that becomes unlimited. So the insured, therefore, it is necessary to have a third party liability. The insured can get his vehicle covered against own damage to the extent of its market value. तो vehicle का जितना market value है उतना insurance वो करा सकता है. तो ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि vehicle is of 10 lakhs and you can get the insurance of 20 lakhs. So that's not possible. So insurance kitne tak ka hoga? Jitni uski market value hai. Aur market value jo hai, that is calculated by taking into consideration the depreciation amount. So these following risks are covered under the own damage, like any damage caused to the motor vehicle because of fire, explosion, self-ignition or lighting, because of burglary, house breaking or theft, because of riot, or there may be some strike, or there is earthquake, flood, storm, hailstorm. So all these risks are covered under motor insurance. In addition to these, there are certain other liabilities which are also, which this Motor Insurance Act covers. For example, death or personal injury to the owner of the goods or his authorized representative in, if there is a goods vehicle. Then another example could be like liability which is incurring in respect of death or bodily injury of any passenger in case the vehicle is of public service, like Haryana Roadways ki buses hain, to jitne bhi passengers hain, agar koi bhi accident hota hai to uske respect mein if there is some body injury or death, so all the passengers are covered under motor insurance. Then other liabilities can also be there as per the Worker Compensation Act. तो जो ड्राइवर है व्हीकल का या कंडक्टर है या वर्कर्स हैं इन केस ऑफ गुड्स व्हीकल, तो इनकी भी लाइफ और इनकी भी जो बॉडी इंजरी है, दे आर ऑल्सो कवर्ड अंडर मोटर इंश्योरेंस. नेक्स्ट इज एक्सीडेंट इंश्योरेंस. सो एन एक्सीडेंट इज एन अनएंटिसिपेटेड इवेंट, राइट, विच ब्रिंग्स सम अनफॉर्चुनेट कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस. An accident may happen with respect to self. So if there is a self accident, that is called personal accident, or to a property, or there may be some unanticipated liability. So according to this, we have three types of accident insurance. The first one being the personal accident insurance. So in case of personal accident insurance, a sum of money is payable to the assured or his legal representative in the event of his disablement or death resultant of an accident. So it provides coverage against injury resulting from accident. A personal accident policy is a kind of, you can say, variant of life insurance, as it is providing protection, or you can say indemnification against, or assurance against the loss to person in case of permanent or temporary injuries. But unlike life insurance, personal accident policies kya hai? Ye sari annual policies hoti hai. That means every year you have to get it renewed. These policies, they do not cover death due to natural causes. Okay, right? Because these are accident policies, so only accidental death or accidental injury is covered under this. Then property insurance. So in this, any financial loss caused by damage or destruction to the property as a result of some identifiable event jo ki unexpected tha ya unusual tha, to usse hone wala jo bhi financial loss hai, that is covered under property insurance. Then liability insurance. Liability insurance means any risk which is insured in risk that is insured is that of litigation. So risk of lawsuits against the insured due to actions of the insured or others. So liability may arise like, for example, in case of a defective product which is sold, or a person is injured by motor vehicle. So ye sari liabilities arise ho sakti hain, and they are all covered under liability insurance. The next is duty insurance. Duty insurance is normally taken by an importer to cover the payment of actual duty on the imported goods. When imported cargo arrives in India, certain duty is levyable by the custom authorities. So this duty can be insured either by including it in the marine cargo policy sum assured, or by purchasing a separate policy known as duty insurance policies. Then another type is machine breakdown insurance. In this, the insurance is taken to cover expensive plant, machinery and mechanical equipments breakdown, or you can say damage or destruction to such machineries. So this insurance can be taken to cover any type of machinery, plant, equipment, apparatus, whether they are mobile or stationary. Then is rural insurance. Rural insurance is a bigger term. We have certain subcategories under the rural insurance. So various important schemes are provided under rural insurance category. First one being the cattle insurance. So this policy is meant for milk cows, milk buffaloes, bullocks and calves. It provides risk cover of death due to accident, including natural calamities, strikes, riots and terrorism. Then sheep and goat insurance is, as name itself suggests, it covers the death from diseases or accident, including natural calamities, for sheep and goat. Same is with camel, horse, mule, pony, donkey and yak insurance. Then in case of plantation and horticulture insurance, yahan par jo hai insurance di jati hai to the damage caused to the trees. Trees jo hai horticulture ke liye ho sakte hai, means fruit bearing trees ho sakte hai. या हमारी क्रॉप हो सकती है. सो दैट इज़ कवर्ड अंडर प्लांटेशन एंड हॉर्टिकल्चर इंश्योरेंस. सो एनी डैमेज कॉज टू दीज बाय बिकॉज ऑफ सम फायर, लाइटनिंग, स्टॉर्म एट्सेट्रा, सो ऑल दिस इज कवर्ड अंडर प्लांटेशन एंड हॉर्टिकल्चर इंश्योरेंस. नाउ द प्राइस ऑफ दिस क्रॉप इंश्योरेंस दैट चेंजेस विद द टाइप ऑफ क्रॉप. तो जो जिस टाइप की क्रॉप होगी उसके अकॉर्डिंग जो है हमारा प्रीमियम जो है दैट में डिफर. नेक्स्ट इज सेरिकल्चर इंश्योरेंस. सेरिकल्चर मींस सिल्क वॉर्म्स का जो हम कल्चर करते हैं या उनको उनका जो पालन होता है, सेरिकल्चर सिल्क वॉर्म्स की से रिलेटेड है. सो इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज सिल्क वॉर्म इंश्योरेंस. So it covers loss by fire, lightning, storm, impact of railroad, aircraft, etc. और कोई डिजीज के कारण भी अगर सिल्क वर्म्स की डेथ होती है तो दैट इज़ ऑल्सो कवर्ड अंडर सेरिकल्चर इंश्योरेंस. एग्रीकल्चरल इंश्योरेंस जो है इट कवर्स कल्टिवेशन ऑफ बी हाइव्स. सो मिनिमम ऑफ 5 बी कॉलोनीज शुड बी कवर्ड एंड इट शैल बी कंपल्सरी टू हैव दीज बी हाइव्स कॉलोनीज टूगेदर. Then in case of hut insurance, it applies only to those huts used for dwellings and constructed in rural areas. And they must be constructed with the help of financial assistance from some banking or cooperative or some government institutions. And there may be many more, you can say, types of insurance which are specifically as per the need of people living in the rural areas. The next is personal package policy for executives. Now this package policy is designed keeping in mind the specific insurance need of executives or businessmen. It covers loss caused to things like laptop, right, or maybe to their cellular phones, loss of cash, some jewelry may be lost, or some other valuable documents. Then they may need some baggage insurance, kyunki wo transit mein rehte hain to they may lose their baggage, chori ho sakta hai unka. Then they may require some mediclaim policies. Then they may face some accident also, so personal accident insurance. Then liability arise ho sakti hai, to personal liability ko bhi wo cover karna chahte hain, right? So etc. So whatever they think, these business executives, they think they may face certain losses, so all these risks they are
covered under one single, individually अलग अलग पॉलिसी लेने के बजाय दे टेक अ पैकेज इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड पर्सनल पैकेज इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिव्स. सो दिस इज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ नेचर ऑफ इंश्योरेंस. देन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बिजनेस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट दे कैन बी ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स, लाइफ इंश्योरेंस, जनरल इंश्योरेंस एंड हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस. ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ लाइफ इंश्योरेंस हियर. देन लाइफ इंश्योरेंस जो नहीं है, रिमेनिंग ऑल आर जनरल इंश्योरेंस. एंड हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस इज बेसिकली विच कवर्स ओनली पॉलिसीज रिलेटेड टू हेल्थ. देन फ्रॉम रिस्क पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, दैट मीन्स द काइंड ऑफ रिस्क दैट दे आर कवरिंग. तो यहाँ पर जो है द रिस्क कवर हो रहा है, दैट इज पर्सनल रिस्क. पर्सनल रिस्क में भी ऑफ सो मेनी टाइप्स, लाइक पर्सनल कोई भी लाइबिलिटी हो सकती है, पर्सनल लाइफ का रिस्क हो सकता है, हेल्थ का रिस्क हो सकता है. So all that is covered under personal insurance. Property insurance means damage to property. तो risk क्या है यहाँ पे, loss to property. Then in case of liability, so there may be some lawsuits. तो risk is the unlimited liability that can arise because of certain lawsuits. Fidelity guarantee, I've told you it, there may be some embezzlement or there may be some fraud committed by the employees or anyone in the organization. So the organization can take insurance against such kind of activities, and this insurance is known as fidelity guarantee insurance. So these are different types of insurance, and the list is inclusive, means if there are other kind, depending upon the specific requirement of a person or the environment in which the person is living, so the need may be different. So accordingly the type of the insurance may also be there, and that can also be added in this types of insurance. So that is all for today. That covers the topic of types of insurance, and also it covers our third unit. So that is all. Thank you.